Hello YouTube, it's July 1st, 2017, and it's experiment time in my kitchen. And what we're going to talk about starting today is boar oil. Now, people who live in cold or dry or cold and dry climates are always worried about their wooden clarinets cracking. And that is a legitimate concern. A lot of people who live in those climates have instruments that crack. And what a lot of them believe is that by putting a little bit of boar oil and moistening a swab with it, pulling that swab through the clarinet two or three times, maybe once a month, that film, that light film inside the bore of the clarinet will prevent the instrument from drying out and cracking. Now, my hypothesis is that this is total BS, that it doesn't do anything. Why? Well, first of all, and primarily, it's because grenadilla wood is so freaking dense, and the inside of the instrument has been polished to the point that I can't believe that any of this is going to go into that at all. Now, I don't think it's going to go in when you pull it through a swab. I don't even think it's going to go in when I take this barrel, stick it inside this black container, and pour all four bottles of this into there and let it sit for 6 months. So that's my experiment. I'm going to take this poor barrel, which I bought on eBay for 20 bucks. I'm going to put it in here. I'm going to pour all four bottles in. And the next time I'm going to look at it is in January 2018. At that point, I'm going to take the barrel out. I'm going to dry it off. And I'm going to saw it in half. And what we're going to do at that point is I'm going to see whether or not any of the oil has made its way into, through some sort of capillary action, into the wood at all. Now, if it hasn't, and I think it won't, what that means is that if by soaking it for 6 whole months in boar oil, if that doesn't do anything, just imagine how little it does to moisten a swab and pull it through once every month. So what I'm just trying to do is sort of, if this doesn't work, we need to find another solution to drying out and cracking clarinets in these climates. So let's just see if we can put this to bed, and I'll get started right now. Okay, so I've got this barrel, don't cry, and I'm going to take all four of these and I'm going to empty them into now normally boar oil, this jar of boar oil will probably last you, oh I don't know, a lifetime. Blah. But here, oh my god, it really smells. And there you have it. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to tip that over so it's really soaking in there. Okay, bye-bye. We're going to take a look at you in 6 months.
All right, it's 8 months later, and I'm here at the Berkeley Carroll Beta Lab with Ryan Byrne, and we are going to cut this barrel in half. Okay, so it's been soaking in mineral oil for, I don't know, about 8 months, and so let's get started. This is what you saw 8 months ago. It has been soaking. My guess is that when we cut this thing in half, we're going to see no oil that has seeped into this bore at all. All right, so what I'm doing right now is I'm just sort of wiping it off so it doesn't sort of accidentally drip in, so. We're ready to go.
So now, we're gonna turn on the bandsaw. We'll slide this into position.
Step two.
An interesting smell it gives off.
Anything
yeah,
more?
I'm not really seeing. You can really tell that there's almost no difference, but it's hard to tell if.
You can take a peek at that. Yeah, I mean, after you sanded it in particular, I don't see any.
My guess is you'd see something like a gradient of sort of.
You know, like when you dip, like there was that old TV commercial where they would dip like chalk into colored water to show how, like, I would expect to see that, at least some of that.
Yeah, same throughout. And it's hard to tell. I mean, this might just be sawdust.
Yeah.
That. What type of wood is this originally?
This is a granadilla. It's African blackwood. It's actually endangered.
Really?
Yeah.
So I just cut...
You just cut an endangered... you don't have to feel bad because this was made probably 60 or 70 years ago. This has probably played a few hundred concerts in its day. So... All right, so...
It's actually making me feel worse.
Okay. I think this is a definitive pseudoscientific no that the bore oil didn't do a damn thing. So... I'm sure that you in the comments are going to disagree with me, those of you who are in the bore oil business, but so far, I just don't see it. All right, we'll take closer pictures of it so that you can look at it like high resolution and stuff, but thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
All right. Okay, so a quick end note here. I just want to say if your teacher or your band director or a repair person tells you to oil your clarinet, for God's sakes, oil your clarinet. Don't listen to me. I don't do it. I never have. I haven't had a cracked clarinet. I keep my instruments humidified. I keep them at the same temperature, as close to room temperature as possible. If they get cold, I try to bring them up to room temperature both inside and outside at the same time. You don't want to blow into a cold clarinet. That might crack it. So just be careful with your instrument, but I don't personally oil it. If someone tells you to oil it, though, don't listen to me, okay? See you next time. Bye.